Hi, this is Simon with IQRF. On this video, I will show you how simple it is to control your IQRF network. That means how you can send out your commands and receive data from your nodes. The previous video demonstrated how to upload a hardware profile to your transceivers, how to set up a TR configuration, how to bond your nodes to the coordinator, and how to set up a network topology through the discovery process. So that's where we start from. To have a practical example, our first task will be to switch on a red LED on one of our modules. We go to the DPA terminal and we make this window bigger so we cannot see the command line only, but the predefined macros as well. To track the network communication, we switch the lower window to the terminal log. We go to the DPA terminal and as you can see, there are 5 fields to be filled in. The first one is the node address, so let's say we want to control the node number 4. The second word is called peripheral number and defines the peripheral you want to talk to on the selected node. With the right button, you open a list of predefined peripherals such as coordinator node, operating system, different types of memories, LEDs, SPI, temperature sensor, and so on. For our purposes, we choose the red LED. Each peripheral has a list of commands and you can select the right one here. In our case, it's the set on command. By the way, you can modify these peripherals and commands or create your own ones with the custom DPA handler. This provides you with a complete flexibility in using the IQRF. You can have different types of devices in your IQRF network and the hardware profile defines the group of products you want to communicate with. For our purposes, we leave it as a full broadcast. Using the DPA protocol, you can send up to 56 bytes of data which you can enter in this field. We have the command ready now, so we just send it out and we can observe that the red LED on the node number 4 switched on. In the terminal log, you can track the communication, the request from the IDE, confirmation from the coordinator and response from the node. To send the broadcast message, you just change the node address to FF and send out the same command again. We have all the nodes shining red now. To switch them off, you just change the peripheral command to 00 and send the packet out. You can see that working with the protocol is extremely easy. Now let me show you how to read data from your modules. Let's say temperature from the node number 3. We type in the node address, choose the peripheral thermometer and the command get temperature. We send out the packet and we receive the response in instance. With a double click on the response log, we get into the packet inspector where we read the actual temperature in Celsius. If you want a high resolution, you can read the temperature from the 2 following bytes here as well. Now, how to work with macros? Let's say we want to collect temperature from all nodes in your network, and for this, the best is to use the fast response command. You can go to these FRC macros and just click on this 1 byte temperature button. This will fill in your command line and you just send the packet out. Within less than 1 second, you will get the data from all the 5 nodes in your network. When we tick we want to see every last record in the packet inspector, we can read 1 byte temperature for each node right here. There's much more you can do with the IQRF IDE and data control transceivers. To learn some tips and tricks, you can just click on this question mark and then on the area of your interest. In this very useful window, you will find a lot of information how to use the IDE effectively. To learn more about the technology, you can browse on the IQRF.org or watch other IQRF videos. With the IQRF, wireless control of your products is really simple. This video is just a small piece of a complete IQRF video tutorial set. To get a full picture and understanding of the IQRF technology, please watch previous and following IQRF tutorials.